Respected Director Sir, Chairman Sir, and my all senior executive of JK organization and my colleagues. Myself PK Kuila, working in plantation R&D of JK Paper Limited, Raigada.
Myself Pavan Kumar.
Myself Ashutosh Mana, working in plantation extension.
Sir, we are from forest organization of JK Paper Limited, Raigada. The main objective of our organization is to generate quality raw material on sustainable basis for paper production. Quality raw material can only be generated by planting quality planting stock, which is called clone and is produced in our clonal plant production center. Sir, clonal plant production starts with planting of mother plant in sand bed, which is called clonal hedge garden, followed by collection of cutting and planting in mist chamber for rooting. Then after the cutting gets rooted, it is shifted to open nursery where the plants are reared till the farmer takes it for plantation. Sir, we are from tribal pocket of Odisha, where the farmer are very small and marginal. Their cost of living is very bad and economic condition is not good. So the main objective of our plantation R&D is to produce quality, healthy and vigorous planting stock on affordable price. Sir, after attaining IMK, myself, my team and my boss, we decided to work something which will be new and will be cost effective, by which we can reduce the cost of production of plant, and something we'll give to farmer at affordable rate and without any investment. So I took two projects. One is related to material and another is manpower, because in clonal plant production, the two major cost head is material and labor. So I took the first project, that is reduction in cost production by substituting consumption of vermiculite, which is a major raw material used in clonal plant production. The second project related to labor, that is manpower efficiency or productivity improvement through process balancing. My team member, they are present here, and this project has been approved by our plant head, and we have taken 5 review meetings during the project period. Sir, the first project, that is reduction in cost of production by substituting consumption of vermiculite. Sir, this vermiculite is a major raw material which has been using all paper industry since long. And this is a very costly material available only in mines, and the availability is very rare and the supplier also very few. So this is a challenge for us, that how to reduce this vermiculite by substituting with other media available in our ecosystem.
Sir, this is the vermiculite. Previously we were using this media. Consumption was coming 25 gram to 30 gram per plants, and cost was 30 paisa to 40 paisa per plants. It can be substituted with some other media which is available in our ecosystems, like carbonized rice husk, soil, sand, and last one is the coir pith. From coir pith, we have been fully replaced this media vermiculite, and consumption is 8 gram to 10 grams per plants, and cost per cutting is 10 paisa to 13 paisa.
So with this challenge, we started our project, and the methodology taken is taking the reference of back data of research and discussion with other paper industry, what they are using as a media, and steps taken is taking trial with different combination, collection of data and analysis, and based on the analysis, we took pilot scale production. The data showing, we have taken 11 trial during our project, and out of the 11 trial, the coir pith, which has been used 100%, is giving better result than other media combination.
Sir, picture is showing plants which has been grown in different media combinations. All are the same, and there is no difference in terms of health and quality. Plants which has been grown in the 100% coir pith media is also looking good as others, even better.
Then coming to the quantitative and tangible benefits of our project, our project period is consisting of 15 months. In that project period, our estimated vermiculite consumption is 637 metric ton, and against that we have actually used 105.47 ton of vermiculite, and we have substituted coco peat of around 134.43 metric ton. And by doing that, our estimated budget expense of 81.37 lakhs, we have actually spent 30.65 lakhs. So there is a saving of 50.72 lakhs.
Sir, coming to my second project, that is productivity improvement through process balancing. Sir, process means which tech input may be in the form of labor, material, and capital, and create an output which is of greater value to customer and ultimately greater value to organization. And process analysis is a set of concepts or tools which allow us to describe and measure and ultimately improve operating process.
Clonal production involves so many activities. All activities are labor oriented, and this all activities out of the all activities, our the cutting charging is one of the major activities in which we deployed more than 40 to 50% labor each and every day. Cutting charging process have both different kind of workstations. First one is like cutting collection, second one is your processing, third one is the planting, and fourth one is the shifting of planted cutting inside the mix chambers. All workstations have different tasks, but they are quite dependent on each other. When we have started our clonal plant production through apical technology, our productivity was very, very less. It was coming around 600 to 700 cuttings per man day. So we were in tension and tremendous pressures, how to improve this productivity, because with this less productivity, we cannot achieve a huge target of clonal plant productions. So we were discussing with the laborers in this regards, but they were hesitating to do it, they were refusing to do it, and they were giving so many excuses. For this, we were running behind the personal departments, our unions, to get the job done, but it could not happen. So we can say the process was totally imbalanced in that particular working area.
Sir, to balance this situation, total process, we took this as a project, and the methodology taken is understanding the sequence of the process and judging the dependency in different process activity. The steps taken is balancing the line, reducing the lead time, reducing the blocking and starving time, understanding the impact of fatigue on the people, and training, recognizing and rewarding the best and efficient worker. The planning made by our team is identifying the best worker fit for the workstation, giving them training and organizing them for different workstation. Now I am going to explain you how I could achieve this process improvement through the process analysis. Sir, there are four workstation, and for easy understanding I am telling one unit is 100 cutting. If there are one operator in every workstation, the task time is different. Here you can see the workstation 2 is the bottleneck of the total process, which is taking 17 minutes to complete its tasks. By this process step, only the utilization of labor is 50%. That's why we are getting only 705 cutting per person. In the second step, there are one more operator attached in workstation 1 and 2. Here, the task time is different. Though the bottleneck is still workstation 2, the utilization has increased to 60%, and resulting the capacity of process has increased to 941 cutting. In third step, there are seven operator in all, and here the task time is again different, but there is utilization of labor is more, that is 78%, which resulted the improvement of efficiency to 1211 cutting. In fourth step, there are almost 15 operator in total, but all the operation are now in balance, whereby we got 91% utilization of labor, and which resulted 1280 cutting. In fifth step, sir, there is a concept in process analysis where we can club two workstation which are not important, and by which we can reduce the manpower and increase the utilization of manpower. Here we got 97% utilization, and now we can go up to 1371 cutting per person per day.
Then coming to the summary of the process analysis, here we have taken total five steps, and in these processes, though there is an increase in manpower, but the manpower utilization has been increased from 50% to 97%, and the efficiency of the person has been increased, and the number of cuttings has been increased from 705 cuttings to 1371 cuttings. So there is a significant cost reduction in our process analysis. Next. Then coming to the quantitative and tangible benefits of our project. In this project period, there is a net saving of around 5.50 lakhs in terms of labor component.
Sir, Though the tangible benefit seems to be very low, but there is no investment in this project. And there, the benefit is recurring, and there is much more intangible benefit, that is, we could able to balance all the process by efficient utilization of manpower and no imbalance in workload, that we can say there is job satisfaction among employee and increased ownership among the employee and reduced supervision job. Sir, if we compare overall impact on cost per plant, which was the main objective of our project, the cost per plant, which was before the project is ₹2.86, has reduced to ₹2.19. That is saving of 67 paisa per plant. This is my roadmap. Sir, earlier we are thinking how to increase the efficiency and how to substitute this vermiculite, which was a costly material. Now the scenario has been changed. The current state is 1,300 cutting per day per Mondays, and we are using 100% cocopeat. In future, we can go up to 1,400 cutting, and we can use sand and fly ash, which is available in our paper industry, with this media by which we can reduce again the cost. And there is, this cost reduction can also be applicable to other activity also. The steps for holding up again is now we can contractualize the job, and the use of cocopeat we can use in consistent basis. These are the learning from IMK. Sir, I am very much thankful to you and total corporate body to provide me the opportunity to learn and implement in my project area. Thank you, sir.